And that little thing costs God's people so much. What happens is they start to think like God is trying to coerce them into something, and they're scared that, well, if we trust my marriage to God, my family to God, my financial, if I do that, what if it all falls apart? What if it turns out that God isn't as good as he said he is? And you struggle, and many Christians struggle their whole Christian life, and they still go to heaven, but they'll turn up in heaven and there'll be a movie playing of this most extraordinary, exciting life, full of breakthroughs and answers to prayer and miracle healings and abundance and coming over challenges, and they'll look at the angel that's playing the movie, they'll say, whose life was that? And the angel will say, well, that was supposed to be yours. But because that one little thing just didn't yield, just didn't want to. I get it. I'm as human as you. Plenty of bits in me. It's called the flesh, really. Plenty that doesn't want to yield. And every now and then I cross the stupid line. And I think, oh, I don't want to do it. These days I last there for about 10 seconds. I think, Paul, come on. Get your faith into gear, son. Get your act together here. What are you doing? Really? You're really going to resist God? You really? Come on. Oh, I've got to. And that can be all kinds of things. Forgiveness. You know, getting ticked off with people. Nobody gets ticked off with me. It's amazing. But I get ticked off with other people. Can you believe that? But yielded. That's the thing that opens every door. Give me yielded people. Only need a dozen. We'll change the world.